Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the next video about where I show how we can format imported content from other sites with the custom markup plugin. So in the last video we did create the ebook-like layout, yeah. And as you can see, I defined this element, the angle element, defined it as a div, yeah. So if I have a closer look, you can see all those elements are divs now. Yeah? And this also happens in some pages in the internet, yeah? So if they are defined in a special way. So let's copy this content, and if I paste it, then you can see everything is pasted as without any paragraph markers. Yeah? So now there are several things that we can do. At first I can mark everything, and there is a new button, it's this one. So it's a new line character at the end of every line, yeah? So it's Control Shift Enter. Yeah? So if I mark everything and say Control Shift Enter, then it goes to every line and it will add some paragraphs. Yeah? So that's the first thing that we can do, yeah? If we don't want to do this, there is another possibility. We can mark these elements, and as you can see, there are more glyphs that we can select. We basically needed them because of the different keyboard layouts different users may have, yeah? So for some users, the angle brackets may be difficult to type, yeah? In French keyboards they may be easy to type, yeah? And so on. There is the single bracket, then there is the tick, yeah? There is the degree sign, the angle bracket, then this is approximation, and this is the Pilkraw character. Yeah? Okay, those three elements, they work default with paragraphs. Yeah? So if I assign them to the start of a line, then it searches until it finds the next two carriage returns. Yeah? So for example, if I define it like this and have a preview, then you can see it will indent the whole thing until it finds two line breaks. Yeah? So if I create the line break here, then it defines two line breaks. Yeah? So those elements, yeah, which have two lines are for two line breaks. And those elements which have one line, yeah, the first three, they work with lines. So if I switch it, and if I say mark everything, and then I toggle it, then you can see it defines a div with those classes to every line. Yeah? And now it's possible to format elements like this if you want to. Yeah? So yeah, that's a possibility. Or you mark everything and you say add some new lines. Yeah. What else can we do? We now can redefine it and can say, okay, I want to have a custom definition for the single element, and I want to have it to be a paragraph. Let's have a look. And now it's a paragraph. And then I can say I want to define some classes. Oops. And I want to define some text indent, and so on. Yeah? So yeah, that's a possibility with some global settings, only adding one little character. And with the global settings, you can define how the new layout should look like. Yeah? And this is very, very powerful. And the global settings are always overridden here. So for example, if I say I want to have this a div again, then right click It's a diff now. So the settings that are applied, first it uses the global settings, and then the local settings always win. Okay, yeah, that's basically it. If you copy some content from a different site, there is a possibility to find this, to define this also. Okay, the next video, we will have a closer look how we can copy to clipboard. We can use the macro copy to clipboard with the text like this. See you soon.